I was commissioned by the Duchess of Northumberland to produce 8 water sculptures to be deployed within the Serpent Garden, designed by Peter Wertz, with whom I have been closely collaborating. And this was the site before the opening of the garden. And here is the site 1 week before the grand opening. The serpent is symbolized by a low winding hedge of Ilex crinata, a species of holly that runs down the center of the garden to a point where it divides into 2 diverging hedges that encircle a paved area. This represents the serpent's mouth and is the location for the most prominent of my sculptures, Torricelli. The other 7 are arranged on each side of the serpent within circular enclosures of yew, which are partially separated from one another, allowing passage through the garden and enabling one to visit each feature one by one. Torricelli, an Italian mathematician of the 17th century, was fascinated by the properties of hydrostatic pressure. That is to say, the pressure derived from the head, or distance between surface and points below. I've applied this principle to the piece I've called Torricelli. A pool of rising ground overlooking the serpent garden overflows via an internal weir, filling up the sculpture below via underground pipework. One can observe the water rising within the transparent tubes to a point where it is level with the surface of the nearby pool, representing the head of water that has been reached. A pneumatically powered valve below ground opens to release the hydrostatically charged water into a circular manifold that feeds 90 jets that leap vertically up and then gradually subside in unison with the dropping levels visible in the acrylic tubes. When these jets have all but died, the valve closes, allowing the system to fill again and the cycle to continue. Coander. This piece takes its name from Henri Coander, who has been called the father of fluid dynamics and who was particularly intrigued by the way fluids cling to surfaces. And this came to be called the Coander effect, here demonstrated on an overhanging surface where water is allowed to spill over the edge of this bowl and adhere to its underside, converging towards the central trunk, down which it descends to a reservoir below. Starburst. Water is jetted up from below onto a circular disc of toughened glass, set in a tank at ground level, inviting one to walk upon it. Droplets burst and radiate, changing and transmuting as they travel to the outer limits of their world, until they reach a moment at which they appear unable to hold on any longer and reluctantly drop away into the abyss below. Water glass. A single curtain in the form of a transparent, clear, unbroken membrane of falling water wraps around a circular enclosure that can be entered and experienced from within, the outer views seen through the thin film of water. Meniscus. Here, 3 distinct and contrasting states are contained within one sculpture. The flat and apparently still reflecting top surface moves imperceptibly from the horizontal into a vertical plane, which is then divided into a multitude of falling threads. Ravine. This demonstrates a state of water known as roll wave. 2 mirror-polished stainless steel monoliths stand together allowing just enough room to pass in between. Water flows down the surfaces of the stainless steel, creating roll wave patterning, where the thin film of water is pulled by surface tension into rhythmical wave patterns. The water creeping and rippling down the surfaces appears to dissolve the substance of the structure beneath, rendering it apparently as translucent.